Hello everyone, my name is Helen and welcome to my channel. If you are new to my channel, I am so glad you're here. My channel is all about scrapbooking, card making, and paper crafting. So today I have for you a 10 cards one kit using Stampin' Up's Feels Like Frost designer series paper and the Frosted Foliage stamp set. Now the stamp set is not available, but the designer series paper is still available. They actually brought it back this year. So all the things I used in this process video, I will link down below. So let's get started. I did bring in some dies and I chose the Spellbinders Essential Rectangle dies, and you can see it right there. And I used it to die cut those little tiny holes on my pattern paper, and I just wanted to kind of add a little elegant touch to this to these cards, because these cards are very, very simple, and I picked these images because they're real photographs, and I kind of wanted to show that off just by embossing some silver embossing powder. And you saw me using my powder tool, and I'm just using that so that when I stamp my sentiment on the paper, it won't go all over the place, and that, you know, it's easy for me to just tap it without it going where I don't want it to go. So that's a helpful tool to use when you're embossing anything on your cards or your scrapbook pages. I also use that powder tool to take off any stickiness behind my stickers if I wanted to add some double-sided foam behind it to add more dimension. And so that is one of my, I would say, top five tools that I use for card making as well as scrapbooking. So from the stamp set, it's I picked the three sentiments that came with it, and you can see it right there. And basically, if there's a huge space, I'll pick the biggest one, or like, I just tried to use each of the sentiments at least two times. And yeah, and I'm using my Versamark ink and a Stampin' Up silver embossing powder. Now you can also try to match other embossing powders to this, like, you know, white or even bronze or copper, but I felt like I like to narrow down what I'm gonna use so that I'm not getting overwhelmed with a lot of supplies. So I did just pick one die, I picked one stamp set, I picked one colored embossing powder. That way I'll be more efficient, and I just wanted to show off the photographs from this paper collection, because they are just beautiful. And I got this paper collection last year along with the matching stamp set here, and I love it. But this year Stampin' Up! Came out with something similar to this. Like, when I buy Christmas stamp sets or paper, I love snowflakes and I love snowmen. I don't know what it is, but I'm drawn to snowmen. And I did order the brand new paper this year, but it hasn't come yet. But I'll do a little small haul video for you guys when it does come, so you can see what I'm talking about, and I will share that with you when it comes. So I'm backing this up with some glitter paper, which is inexpensive for Michaels. The glitter doesn't come off of the paper. It's actually really nice, and I actually prefer this because, one, it's reasonable in price, and two, the glimmer from the glitter paper is really pretty. And I know the video doesn't do it any justice, like you can't really see it, but If you see it in person, you will see what a huge difference it makes to the card because it's peeking through the holes and it just adds like a nice touch of elegance to these cards. Now, they are very simple, but yeah, I think these would make great cards to give to coworkers or teachers or just quick, simple cards to give to anybody, honestly. And yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and adhere the last glitter paper behind my pattern paper. Now, I did trim those glitter paper down to an eighth of an inch smaller than the pattern paper. And then now I just brought in some cardstock which matches the pattern paper. And on the Designer Series paper pack itself, it says what color matches with it. And that's why I like Stampin' Up! Because a lot of their papers will match with their cardstock. And so I just picked three, which is Purple Posy, Seaside Spray, and Night of Navy. And honestly, I really love how the purple looks with the DSP. But since some of these pattern paper has the blue tones and doesn't have the purple tones, I had to bring in some blue, and I just cut those cardstocks to 4 by 5 1/4, so that when I put it on my white card base, it will have a nice white border. And by also adding in the glitter paper behind the pattern paper, it actually makes my card feel thicker. Now, I wasn't worried about wasting the center of the glitter paper because, like I said, the glitter paper was very reasonable. I think I bought it during Black Friday last year, and I want to say it was probably 50 cents at Michael's. And it is one sheet, but you can't beat that price, I don't think. I've never seen glitter paper go for 50 cents a sheet. Usually they'll sell it for like 2 for $5, like in other places or other catalogs. So I think like if I should have bought like a whole stack of it, honestly. But I didn't think of that. So now I'm just going to finish off these cards by adding some jewels. Now, I thought about like scattering it all over the place, but I didn't do that because I didn't want to distract the image. So what I did was I just put the jewels around the sentiment, and I narrowed it down to just three jewels. And these jewels come from Pink Fresh Studio, and I will also link that below. And I picked it's like an iridescent white or silver, I'm not sure. But in this video, you can't tell, but it actually takes on the color of the paper, like as it, like the color bounces off of the iridescent jewel. So in like right here you can see that it did that, but on some of them you can't tell because of my lighting or the surrounding area where I'm crafting. So some you can tell that it's grabbing the color of the paper and some you just can't. But overall, like I was really happy with how these cards turned out. It was really simple. Like I thought about adding ribbon, but I was like, no. And then I wasn't worried about not using the back of it because, as you saw, like the back has like some foil detail. Like when you get the paper pack, it comes with 10 patterns, 4 of each sheet. So that is a lot to play with. So, like one day I could just play with the silver foil sheet on the back of this pattern papers. So I wasn't really like sad about not using it. Honestly, I think like the picture side is the best side of this collection because it's rare you see pattern paper that are real photographs. Usually I'm not drawn to real photograph pattern paper because it's just hard to, I guess, work with it, if that makes any sense. Like, especially if you're a scrapbooker or like, the card making, maybe it might be easier, but this one, I think, like the sentiments, you can use any sentiments you have. So it doesn't have to just be this stamp set. Like any winter holiday themed, Christmas themed sentiments can work for this paper collection. Or even if you have like other pattern papers, try this idea. I mean, it was so much fun. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I will see you on my next video. Have a wonderful day. Bye.